guys, and welcome back to Pink's Place Pokemon Emerald. In the last part, we beat the Rustboro Gym, and we got ourselves a Lotad that we nicknamed Carlos, and now we're going to see what's going on with the this guy's goods. He's a fantastic trainer. Help me head over to the woods, I mean. Tell me, I was robbed by Team Aqua. I have to get the devil goods back. If I don't, I'm going to be in serious trouble. Okay, so this guy lost his stuff, I guess. It's some company property, I assume, and so we already went into a wild Pokemon. Wonderful. It's a Talo. We haven't run into one of these in a while yet, but we didn't run into one in a trainer battle, which, you know. But now we've seen one in the wild. We do have the possibility to catch it, but that's not going to be part of my team. I'll let y'all know when I do have a Pokemon that I have saved for my team. So now, Carlos grew a level. And he learned Absorb, sweet. Alright, so starting to get more moves for Carlos, getting experience for both of our Pokemon, and it's a Whismur, awesome. It's a my best friend actually made me a my best friend actually made me a like a Whismur crocheted little stuffed toy. It's really awesome. I'll if I can get a picture up, I'll put it in right now. See this Pokeball, it's a Repel, that's always nice. And there are no Pokemon on this route that I even want anyways for my team, so it's ideal time to use it. And what the Repel does, if you don't know, it keeps you from running into wild Pokemon that are higher or equal level to the Pokemon you have out on the top of your team. But if it is higher than you, it will pop out, but if it's lower, it'll, you know, you won't run into any. Let's switch to the first move. This will turn the bell. And quickly take care of this guy. And Carlos grew to level 8, and get some more experience here. I'm going to be switching him out a lot until he gets up in level, because still pretty weak, he didn't know that good moves yet, and I don't want to get him up in level so he can be more useful to the team. And keep using annoying Harding to make this fight last as long as possible. And that Pokemon is ugly as heck. I must say, I really don't like the design on that one, but, you know, there's always somebody who likes the design for a Pokemon, so I can't completely fault it. Because I'm sure it was made, you know, with some mindset in mind, it's for somebody to like it. Okay, looking at that sprite, it looks like her eye is just like hanging there, like it's looks really out of place. Her right eye just looks really out of place there. But anyway, so she's got a Shroomish, and still too low level for Carlos to fight, but Ultra Speed can take care of, you know, most threats right now. I mean, he's pretty high level, so. Ooh, our Horn Berry to effect. Carlos grew to level 9. And we got some more experience in Ultra Speed, and yeah. We sent out a Geodude. I think I'll just skip and see how this goes. Whoa! That went very well. I was not expecting it to do that much damage. I know it's super effective, but still. It was almost a 1 KO. So now he's level 10? Looks like, you know, we can finally, like, efficiently use him on the team. So I'm going to wait for this guy to turn, because I want to do a double battle. Turn. There we go. I could have just, like, went back a little bit and sprinted, and it would have turned towards where I was going so you can see me, but oh well. So, and then we get this double battle with the hacker and a youngster. We're going to send out a Shroomish and a Geodude to start off with, and so I'll absorb all the Geodude to attack all the Shroomish. Oh well, critical. Sweet. Yeah. I mean, Lotad's stats are weak at the beginning, but they do quickly grow. He can become a very useful member of any team if you know how to use him. His final evolution, well, it becomes a powerhouse. Oh, wow. So we got a Lotad now. The fight ends 2 levels lower than Carlos here, and our current stats for Carlos is looking pretty good so far. For, you know, level 11, it's not bad at all. Took care of this fight with ease. Got some more experience for our guys, and now we've beaten everyone on this route that we can fight currently. Well, we can fight the trainers over there, but we don't have the cut agent yet, so we can't really do anything right now. Oh no, his darling Pico has been stolen by King Aqua. There's a cave that links two towns. That was a bit far off. That's the other town that links to. Well, no, that's not the town, that's a like old little area they can exit from, but anyway, so let's go in here, and oh, there's an item up here. There's Team Aqua with a Wingull. It's got a Pokeball. So of course we gotta run to a Wild Whisper to continue to take care of this guy real quick. I might cut out wild encounters just because, you know, they take a time for best wording and still, you know, takes up a chunk of time that could be used for other things, so, yeah. I might cut them out, we'll see, depending on if I feel like the thing takes too long, then I'll cut it out, but if it's just, like, really quick, I'll just leave it in. So anyway, so, here's the Team Aqua thug. He, like, backed up from us, scared of a kid. But this might be the same Team Aqua guy that we beat before. I was gonna switch to... Oh wait, it's paralyzed, forgot. It's probably an issue. Probably got to heal a bit. I think I'm gonna heal and I'll come back and then I'll fight. Well, let's see what I have. I believe that one of the berries I have heals. Yes, it heals paralysis. So I don't even need to. Never mind, I'm not gonna get up after all. I'll heal after this battle though. I think I will use a potion on Super Speed just because. Oh, I don't feel like having to lose and then come back and, you know, lose some money and then not. I think I'll switch out. Because, I mean, Carlos is still fairly weak at Holy Ghost Absorb currently. So, and like I said before, the Team Aqua Grunts have the same generic teams. You know, Uchianas and, that's pretty much like their extent of what they'll use in battle. So we defeated this. And then... So... This is more foreshadowing to, you know, Team Aqua as a gang instead of just like a couple of thieves. So, if you remember that boat that I mentioned outside of Heidelberg City. That's that old man's boat. What it does is it can take me to places that I can't get to until I get surf, which I obviously don't have surf yet. So it can take me to the other islands that are on the map. Oh, there's a train we didn't find. Anyways, and we're back. I wanted to get on that fight because it took a bit longer than I expected it to. And of course, we run into another ugly bug creature. Ugh. Do not like this Pokemon one bit. I'll just quickly use Need for Speed on it. Just get rid of it. But it's gone now, finally. So we can battle this trainer real quick. And get some experience in. Go to the chat. Yeah, I think we can take it. Oh, never mind. Unless we get a really good critical here. Yeah, I'm gonna disengage. I can't attack him anymore. Astonish. I want to attack him because he's a fighting type Pokemon, and Growl will just lower his attack, so that won't really do much. So I need to bring out Need for Speed to finish him off. But anyway, so we got the Devin Goods, brought it back to this guy. And he's praising me for just doing that for him, and he gave us another Great Ball, which is that's pretty nice. And so now we can. He's gonna take us to Devin Corp, and we get to meet the president of the Devin Corp. Just confess with this dialogue. I don't know why, but that guy kind of reminds me of Maze Hughes. Not thinking about it, just I don't know why, but he kind of reminds me of Maze Hughes from Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood. So this is Mr. Stone, the president of the Devin Corporation, and he's like what the Devin Corporation is like a technological business. And so we get got a letter, and he's also going to give us the PokéNav, which allows us to contact people we meet on our journey. And you can actually rebattle trainers with the use of that by calling them, and if they like, sometimes they'll just say the same generic dialogue like, I almost got this Pokemon, but I failed. Sometimes they'll, say that they want to battle you, which is pretty nice. It helps you level up Pokemon or get money in case you're short on cash, before getting to the Elite Four. Because, once you have your Pokemon high enough level, the Elite Four is basically just for training weaker Pokemon and, getting a lot of money. Because, they give you, 10 to 12,000 for beating just one of them. I do that a lot. If I'm short on money and I need to buy something expensive within the game, if I want to buy a bunch of vitamins, the irons and the calciums and proteins, I just go through the Elite Four a handful of times, and it gets me a lot of money and more than plenty enough to buy a good handful of the vitamins. So. And what was that sound? It was really weird. It's like, what did he do to our PokéNav? Anyways, that's the match call feature, which allows me to call people. Okay, so now we're forced to please select the PokéNav. This is unavoidable. I have to go down to the match call and talk to Mr. Stone. So, now we've done that, we got our PokéNav, we got the precious Devin goods. so now we're done here. And I think this is a good point to stop. And yeah, I think I'll go and stop here, heal my Pokemon. And I think I'll continue next time, so in the next part we'll, you know, go take the Poet and deliver our package and everything, and yeah, so thanks for watching, I'll see you guys next time, bye-bye.